Hello everyone. Today we will be covering National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Diseases and Stroke. In short form, this is called NPCDCS. And why this program is very important, we will come to know. Non-communicable diseases kill around 41 million people each year, and that is equal to 70% of all the deaths which are occurring globally. Each year, around 15 million people die from NCD between the ages of 30 to 69 years, and 85% of these are premature deaths, which occurs in low and middle income countries. Cardiovascular diseases account for most NCD deaths, or you can say around 17.9 million annually. After that, cancers are the second leading cause. They causes around 9 million deaths. After that, the respiratory diseases around 3.9 million and diabetes around 1.6 million. So these four groups of diseases, they account for more than 80% of all the premature deaths. These cardiovascular diseases, cancers, respiratory diseases and diabetes. Tobacco use, physical inactivity and the harmful use of alcohol, unhealthy diets, all these increases the risk of dying from NCD. Detection, then screening and treatment, and as well as palliative care. These are the key components of response towards the NCDs. So during the 11th five-year plan, Government of India identified some 100 states in 21 states, and they covered these 100 states under this program. In 12th five-year plan, this program of NCD was launched in all over India. This program we will cover in two parts. In one part we will cover diabetes, cardiovascular disease and stroke, and another part we will cover cancers. So the major objective of this program are to prevent and control common NCD through behavior and lifestyle changes, to provide early diagnosis and management of the common NCDs which are occurring in specified area, build capacity at various levels of healthcare for prevention, diagnosis and treatment of common NCDs, train the human resources within the public health setup like doctors, paramedics, nursing staff to cope up with the increasing burden of NCD, and establish and develop capacity for palliative and rehabilitative care. So first we have to build the capacity. We need infrastructure. Okay, when we have infrastructure, we have to train the human resources, our staff. In the first phase of implementation, this was started in 20,000 sub-centers and around 700 community health centers when it was started in 100 districts and in 21 states. The strategies include promoting healthy lifestyle through massive health education and mass media, efforts at country level, opportunities screening of persons above the age of 30 years, establishment of non-communicable diseases clinic at community health centers, and district level development of trained manpower and strengthening of tertiary level health facilities. So when it was started, so the main focus was on education, health education, then the screening. All those who are 30 or above, they have go for screening for non-communicable diseases, and one clinic was to be established at CSCs, at district level hospitals, and all the health personnels have to be trained for NCDs. The various approaches such as mass media, community education and interpersonal communication will be used for behavioral change. So it is not easy to change a behavior of someone, but all these approaches together will be used and being used for NCDs. So focus on these messages: increased intake of healthy foods, increased physical activity, avoidance of tobacco and alcohol, and stress management. Health promotion for behavior and lifestyle change will be carried out by organizing various camps, interpersonal communications, posters, banners, etc. And for screening of population above 30 years for BP and diabetes at various camps or facility based. For screening of diabetes up to the subcenter level, the glucometers are provided. Even to measure the BP, BP apparatus are provided. And those who are screened in this program, and those who are, there's a guidelines which we will cover further, there must be a referral system from one institute to another institute. The NCD clinic at CSC shall do the diagnosis by required investigations, tests like blood sugar measurement, lipid profile, ultrasound, X-ray and ECG, etc. Management and stabilization of common cardiovascular diseases, diabetes and stroke cases, outpatient as well as inpatients have to be managed as these clinics. One of the nurses appointed under the program shall undertake home visits for bedridden cases, supervise the work of health workers, and attend monthly clinics being held in the villages on a random basis. These nurses are appointed in few states, and in few states these are not appointed because this work is handled by some other functionaries of health in various states. Complicated cases of diabetes, high blood pressure, etc. shall be referred from CSC to district hospital for further investigation and management. At CSC level, this NCD clinic thinks that this person requires a specialist opinion, then that person has to be referred to the district hospital for further investigation and management. Screening at NCD clinic. Detailed investigation management of screened and referred from field. People with established cardiovascular disease shall also managed at district hospital. They shall provide home-based palliative care for chronic, debilitating and progressive patients. Those require home treatment. The NCD clinic, with help of the supporting staff of the field, should provide the palliative care at home. Apart from clinical services, district hospital shall be involved in promotion of healthy lifestyle through health education and counseling to the patient and their attendants, those who are attending the NCD clinic at district hospitals. So when this program was launched, then majorly the rural areas were covered, and with pace of time, the urban health checkup scheme for diabetes and high pressure was also included in this program. So with following objectives: first one, to screen urban slum population for diabetes and high blood pressure, to create database for prevalence of diabetes and high blood pressure in the urban slums, to sensitize the urban slum population about healthy lifestyle. The blood sugar and blood pressure will be checked for all 30 years and all pregnant women of all age. The NCD cells at the center, state and district will implement and monitor the national program for prevention and control of cancer, diabetes, stroke in various states, those who have the urban slums. The national NCD cell has been established at the center to monitor these all activities. So when you refer when from a lower health center to the upper center, there are some guidelines which has to be followed. Those with the systolic blood pressure of over 140 and a diastolic pressure of 90 mm of Hg or random blood sugar of 140 mg per deciliter and above would be referred to a medical officer at the nearest facility for confirmation, conducting relevant laboratory investigation and initiation of treatment. For example, at subcenter level, some health worker, the field supporting staff, was doing a camp, and she found that out of 100, some 8 persons are having blood sugar random, more than 140 mg Hg. They have to fill a referral form and to be sent to the covering primary health center for further diagnosis, because with one reading you can not label one person either it's a diabetes or not. Similarly, if someone is having the BP more than 140 and 90 millimeter of Hg, has to be checked by the medical officer of the concerned area. And if the medical officer found these positive in the screening or in the NCD clinic, has to be established whether this person has to be labeled as diabetes or not, or has to be labeled as hypertensive or not. Once the medical officer labeled him as a diabetic or hypertensive, then he or she must supply the drugs from the PSC. Once the condition of the patient seems stable, then the medical officer in charge of that area can provide the drugs for 3 months. And after 3 months, the patient has to be come for regular checkup. And for regular checkup, the duty is fixed of the ASHA, where the ASHA is available, or the ANM of that area in which the patient is living. Alternatively, a 3-month drug supply could be stocked with the ANM at subcenter to be given each month. Once you see the patient is tolerating the drugs and he is stable, then you can send the drugs to the ANM or ASHA for 3 months. But every 3 months, he must have a checkup. Once patient is leveled, put on drugs, so when the patient is not stable, till that he needs the follow-up checkup with the concerned medical officer. And or medical officer of that concerned area thinks that this patient who has been labeled as diabetic or hypertensive or other cardiovascular diseases need a specialist opinion, then that concerned area medical officer should refer that patient to the further tertiary level, either to CSC level, NCD clinic, or to the district NCD clinic for further investigation or management. But this decision has to be taken by the medical officer of the concerned PSC. Second component of this program is the cancer. So cancer, this is also a very important public health problem in India. Around 10 lakh new cases occurring every year in India. And it is estimated that there are around 2.8 million cases of cancer in the country at any given point of time. With the objective of prevention and early diagnosis and treatment, the National Cancer Control Program was launched in 1975-1976. In view of the magnitude of the problem and gaps in the availability of the cancer treatment facilities across the country, this program, which was launched in 1975-1977, was re-revised and it was relaunched in 84-85, and then again it was re-revised and launched in 2004 with the newer guidelines. But during 2010, this program, which was running alone as a cancer prevention program, this was merged with the diabetes, cardiovascular and stroke. So what are the objectives of this program? The first objective is the primary prevention of cancer by health education. Secondary prevention is early detection and diagnosis of common cancers such as cancer of cervix, mouth, breast and tobacco related cancers by screening, self-examination methods. And the third, the tertiary component, is strengthening of the existing institution for comprehensive therapy including palliative care. So primary prevention will be done by health education. You can know how we can impart the health education. Secondary, by early diagnosis and treatment. And tertiary prevention, we should strengthen our palliative care. Cancer services under National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, CVD, AIDS, Stroke, etc. So what are the services under this program? Common diagnostic services, basic surgery, chemotherapy and palliative care for cancer cases is being made available at 100 district hospital in the starting. Now it is reached to all hospitals, almost all states. each district is being supported with ₹1.6 crore per annum for the following. Chemotherapy drugs are provided for 100 patients at each district hospital. Now this number of 100 patients in some state is not valid. Now you provide for everyone who attend this chemotherapy clinics. Day care chemotherapy facility is being established at 100 district hospitals. Now it is almost in every district hospital in the country. Facility for laboratory investigation including mammography is being provided at 100 district. Similarly, it is now more than the 100 district where it is available, it is being provided. Home-based palliative care is being provided for chronic debilitating and progressive cancer patients at 100 district. This component is still lacking. It is provided in some district and it is not being provided in other district due to the lack of various factors like human resources. Support is being provided for contractual manpower through one medical oncologist, cytopathologist, cytopathology technicians, nurses for daycare. Some states are using this and some states are not using because they have their own staff. State Cancer Institute will be provided comprehensive cancer diagnosis, treatment and care services. The State Cancer Institute will be a PACS institution in the state for cancer treatment for activities. And 45 centers were to be strengthened as tertiary care centers, TCC, to provide comprehensive cancer care gaps in the availability of cancer treatment facility in the country. Then the decentralized NGO scheme. This scheme is meant for IC activities and early detection of cancer. The scheme is operated by the nodal agencies and the NGOs are given financial assistance for undertaking health education and early detection activities of cancer. Those NGOs who are involved in health education imparting related to cancer or non-communicable diseases, they are given the financial support. And what are the IC activities which are taken care by the central level? The central level, they have the wider publicity about the anti-tobacco legislation for discouraging consumption of cigarettes and other tobacco-related products and for creating awareness among masses about the ill effects of consumption of tobacco and tobacco-related products. Under this scheme, wider publicity would also be given about the rules being formulated for implementation of various provisions of anti-tobacco legislations. November 7th is observed as a National Cancer Awareness Day in the country. Research and training. Training programs, monitoring and research activities will be organized at the center level under this program. The following training manuals are prepared at center level and these manuals are used for training and also available online. Manual for health professionals, manual for cytology, manual for palliative care, manual for tobacco cessation. They are manuals for ASHAs and different type of health workers separately available. So a little bit about the tobacco control in India. A comprehensive tobacco control legislation titled the Cigarettes and Other Tobacco Products, Prohibition of Advertisement and Regulation of Trade and Commerce Production, Supply and Distribution Act 2003 was passed by the Parliament in April 2003 and notified in Gazette of India on 25th February 2004. So what are the important provisions on this act? Prohibition of smoking in public places. You can't smoke in public places. Prohibition of direct and indirect advertisement of cigarette and other products. You cannot advertise cigarettes and tobacco products on any medium like television, radio or billboards, anything. Prohibition of sale of cigarette and other tobacco products to a person below the age of 18 years. Cannot sell any tobacco products who is less than 18 years. Prohibition of sale of tobacco products near the education institute, 100 yards, you cannot sell any tobacco products near the institutions. Mandatory depiction of stationery warnings, including pictorial warnings on tobacco packs. Mandatory depiction of tar and nicotine contents along with maximum permissible limits on tobacco packs. The rules related to prohibition of smoking in public places came into force from the 2nd October 2008. As per the rules, it is mandatory to display smoke-free signages at all public places. Labeling and packaging rules mandating the depiction of specified health warnings on all tobacco products packs came into force from 1st May 2009. On 24 September 2015, Government of India notified that the rule on tobacco pack pictorial warnings would come into effect from 1st April 2016. And these rules mandate display of pictorial health warnings on 85% of the principal display area of tobacco product pack on both sides, 60% of the picture and 25% of the text. So, what is National Tobacco Control Program? In order to facilitate the implementation of the tobacco control laws, which you just heard earlier, so, to bring about greater awareness about the harmful effects of tobacco and to fulfill the obligation under the WHO Framework Convention on Tobacco Control, Government of India has launched a new National Tobacco Control Program in the 11th Five-Year Plan. And this National Tobacco Control Program was pilot in some 16 districts covering 9 states in 2007-8 and now it's covering around 108 districts in 31 states of the country. The main components of this program are public awareness, mass media campaigns for awareness, building. The main components of this tobacco control program are public awareness, mass media campaigns for awareness, building and behavior change. Establishment of tobacco product testing laboratories to build regulatory capacity as required under COTPA Act of 2003, mainstreaming the program components as a part of the health delivery mechanism under the NRHM framework, mainstream research and training on alternate crops and livelihood with other nodal ministers. So those who are producing tobacco, they should be provide alternatives, monitoring and evaluation including surveillance, example adult tobacco survey, dedicated tobacco control cells for effective implementation and monitoring of anti-tobacco initiatives, training of health and social workers, NGOs, school teachers, etc., school program and provision of tobacco cessation facilities at various levels. If somebody wants to quit, then there should be help available for him or her. So what are the new initiatives under this NPCDCS program? Intervention for prevention and control of rheumatic heart diseases under NPCs is added, and it is also added with the Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakram, in where in the schools you have to do the annual checkup of the children, and any children who found suffering from any cardiovascular diseases or any other non-communicable disease is covered under this program. Integration of Ayush with NPCDCS like yoga, etc. are included now. Integration of RNTCP. Now this is not RNTCP, this is now the NTEP, National Tuberculosis Elimination Program. And in those who are diagnosed with the tuberculosis, they must be checked for diabetes and hypertensive. So these are the main new initiatives which are covered under this NPCDCS program. And why this program is very important in the point of view of practice as well as the examination point of view. So you just saw that around 70% of the total deaths are occurring from these non-communicable diseases. If you have 100 deaths, 71% of the deaths will be caused by this NCD. And recently you can see in this global pandemic of this COVID-19, you can see the maximum deaths, more than 80% of the deaths are occurring in those patients who are suffering from non-communicable diseases like kidney diseases, diabetes, hypertensive, all those patients who are chronically ill and infected with the COVID-19, they have the highest chances of death. And if you see from examination point of view, so this question of NPCD yesterday The post graduation exam was held for Himachal Pradesh University, and this question, this program was asking that question also. So this topic is very important on both the point of view, in the examination point of view also, and in the practice. When you finish your studies, you will be, the patients will be coming to you with lot of, from hypertensives and lot of diabetes, now cancers, respiratory diseases. So you should know that what other factors, what other facilities, not only the drugs, your job is only not provide the treatment, but other facilities also, that what other help can be provided under these programs to these patients. This lecture is available on YouTube channel and as well as the Facebook, and if you have any queries, you can mail me. Thank you.